Welcome back to another episode of Wiccan's Wicked Reptiles. On today's episode, we're going to go to Toronto. We're going to go to the Reptile Expo. It might seem crazy what I'm about to say. Sunshine, she's here, you can take a break. I'm a hot air balloon that could go to space. With the air, like I don't care, baby, by the way. Our animal purchase for today. This is a well, it's a ball python. It's a male. We popped the hemipenes to find out. I think it's pretty clear that he's a banana morph, but it looks like there's something else as well, and we're gonna get closer in a second here to show that it kind of looks like Enchi patterning. So it might not be Enchi. A lot of people said that's what it was. I asked around at the expo because I'm not the genetics guy. I'm the let's learn about reptiles guy, so I'm not exactly sure, but I am going to breed him, I think, with one of my females. And because banana is a co-dominant gene, that means that the female doesn't have to have banana in her at all, and we can still produce some banana babies. So this guy right here is Zapdos, and he is a fully grown male banana ball python, maybe some mystery gene in him as well. Well, that expo was a great time. I really like going to these expos. You get to meet a lot of cool people. You get to see a lot of really cool animals. We saw that Chinese beauty snake that you'll see right here. Very interesting snake. Usually they're pretty flighty and pretty aggressive. This guy was handling them like it was nothing. It was just a very placid snake. And it's really cool when you get to see snakes that are considered defensive, or even worse, aggressive, being total sweethearts. And that's what I really like about these expos, is you get to see a lot of things that you're not going to see at your normal reptile store, or definitely not at a PetSmart or Petco or wherever you go shopping for your dog food. So I showed you Zapdos that we picked up. Great addition to my collection, I think. He's already producing sperm plugs, so I think that if I can't get Pikachu to breed Medusa, we might try that instead and see what we can do. Because banana is a co-dominant gene, it means that half, on average, of the babies will be banana right off the hop, which is fantastic. Now, I also got another enclosure, and I've got some big plans for this guy. If you want to put in the comment section below what you think it's going to be that I put inside of this enclosure, give it a whirl. I'd love to hear what you think it's going to be. Another great part about expos is you get to ask questions to people who actually know what they're talking about. If you buy on Kijiji or Craigslist, wherever you are, a ball python and you don't know what the genes are, like my boy Zapdos here, you're going to be wondering, what is this? And you don't have a bunch of people to pull besides maybe on groups, but you can't really see the colors and the pattern as well on groups or in pictures as you can in person. So I went around to a bunch of different breeders, a bunch of different tables, and I asked everybody, what do you think this ball python is? And a lot of them said banana, for sure it's a banana. And a lot of them said maybe it's Enchi or even cinnamon. So I'm not sure, but when I breed this ball python, if I sell the babies, I'm just gonna sell them as banana and then whatever the other genes of the mother is. Because what you don't wanna do is promise the world and then under-deliver, right? You always under-promise and over-deliver. That's the idea with any good business, and snake-keeping is no different. So that's the episode. Thank you very much for tuning in. If you've never gone to a Reptile Expo, I suggest finding one in your area. They're a lot of fun. You can get really great deals on animals and supplies and all sorts of different things, even feeders. And also, it's just fun to look at all these different types of animals. And I want to mention, too, last week we discussed, or on Monday we discussed, then I'm going to do a little bit of a giveaway. We're going to give away this green WWR shirt. If you're interested in having this, I want to get to 600 subscribers. That was my goal for the first year of this YouTube channel. And we're over halfway there, and we're only 5 months in. So, if you like, share, and subscribe, I will put you into the draw. And we're going to do that draw as soon as I hit 600 subscribers. If you haven't seen the video, it's right here. And this is the one that you got to comment your name on. We're going to do that draw as soon as we get to 600 subscribers. If we can do it before these baby hognose hatch, that'd be really darn cool. Thanks for coming back, and I'll see you on Monday. Step into the spotlight.